This video will demonstrate a few important aspects of aliasing. You'll be able to see how signals are attenuated by the anti-aliasing filter, and also how incoming signals that are above the specified bandwidth get mirrored about the bandwidth. For this demonstration, I'll be acquiring a sine wave that is sweeping from 200 to 1200 Hz. The top graph has a bandwidth of 2000 Hz. So as the sine wave sweeps up to 1200 Hz, it will be able to capture the frequency range with no aliasing. On the other hand, the bottom graph has a bandwidth of 800 Hz. The black cursor line represents this bandwidth. As the sine wave sweeps to 1200 Hz, the bandwidth will not be high enough to capture the incoming signal without aliasing. Look at the bottom graph. As the incoming signal nears the bandwidth, the signal starts to attenuate or be reduced because of the anti-aliasing filter. When the incoming signal hits the bandwidth, it begins to be mirrored about the bandwidth. Let me pause the acquisition here. You can see that the incoming signal is 50 Hz above the 800 Hz bandwidth. The signal on the bottom graph is being mirrored 50 Hz below the 800 Hz bandwidth at 750 Hz. The anti-aliasing filter will completely attenuate incoming signals that are 20% above the specified bandwidth, therefore leaving 80% of the bandwidth alias-free. This alias-free region is called the span. Thank you for watching.